Our old app is currently 30% Swift and 70% Objective-C. So we had a lot of Objective-C code that was interopted into Swift through Swift headers. And a lot of the time, because of implicitly unwrapped optionals, we would expect some variables to be non-nil. But because for some reason or for some edge case, we had a nil parameter pass through, that would cause lots of bugs. And I think we've had thousands and thousands of crashes in our current app because of that interop issue in general. And that's actually one of the reasons we decided that going 100% Swift is important for both our developer happiness, because this is a much nicer code base to work with, but also for the happiness of our users, who will be able to use a more robust product. So the most common interoperability challenge I've encountered when I'm going from Swift to Objective-C. So my Objective-C code is consuming my Swift code. And the challenge I face is that a lot of the time my Swift code includes structs and enums and other constructs that are specific to Swift only. So it's very difficult, or actually Xcode doesn't make it possible at all to create headers for those in Objective-C. And in order to have your Objective-C code consume that Swift code, you have to create wrapper classes that kind of shimmy your code from Swift to Objective-C, which leads to more lines of code, more files of code, and more complexity, which was probably one of the larger reasons as to why we decided to do a rewrite where we don't run into issues like this. After we completed our nullability audit, it wasn't completely smooth sailing, because we realized that our nullability audit actually exposed some bad practices that we were doing in our Objective-C code base, because sometimes things that shouldn't be nil ever, we were setting to nil, just not realizing that we were. But thankfully, with Apple's toolkit they've given us with Objective-C, and when they introduced nullability audits, so the ability to do them, they give you warnings every time you do set something to nil that's not supposed to be nil. And that was helpful in us improving the quality of our code base, making it more robust by removing those warnings, by making sure we never set those values to nil. Or if they should be nil, by making sure that we make them nullable. There are actually no features that were especially difficult to port from Objective-C to Swift. Mm-hmm. And that's because porting anything from Objective-C to Swift is relatively straightforward, because Objective-C, when you're going from Objective-C to Swift, all the constructs that exist in Objective-C also exist in Swift. So you can literally just go from a syntactical change from Objective-C to Swift. The point of our rewrite, though, was not to port the code one-to-one. It was to make architectural decisions that led to a more robust code base. And that meant a lot of whiteboarding. There were multiple correct solutions, but probably one best solution. So it meant a lot of just meeting as a team and figuring out what that best solution was. And that's where I think our brains worked the most. And it was an engaging, but also a difficult problem to solve. So for the most part, if I was writing a new app, I would write it 100% in Swift, because almost all the features that exist in Objective-C also exist in Swift. That said, if I wanted to do something crazy like method swizzling, I think because Objective-C is a dynamic language, I would do it in Objective-C. That said, I don't think I'd ever be doing method swizzling if I'm doing something the right way. So I would probably go 100% Swift and maybe use some Objective-C dependencies if they make my life easier. But write my main product in Swift, because it gives you all the powers of map and flat map and generics and structs and value types, which is very powerful that Objective-C just doesn't give you.